WLBB Facebook page. I'm your host this morning, Colin Worthington. Our guests representing Tanner, one of our sponsors. We try to get Tanner in a couple times a month. And this month, today, we're talking about a newish campaign they have going on, Better Birthdays. It's about keeping moms and babies safe during pregnancy, childbirth, and beyond. My guest this morning, sitting to my left, is Debbie Boulding. She is a marketing communications specialist guru. And sitting to my right is Dr. Megan Grilliot.
Yes.
And we're going to talk about that campaign this morning. Well, first of all, let's introduce you, ladies. Debbie, have you actually been on this show maybe for just for a second where you pop in and say, all right, we're doing this?
I'm usually lurking in the background, mm-hmm. supporting our speakers.
And I'm sure people have seen you on the Facebook Live sitting in the background there. But go ahead and introduce yourself. I mean, tell us what you do and why somebody, you know, when they bump into you at Tanner, why they would talk to you or seek you out.
Sure. Well, I have a great role, Colin. I was born at Tanner, I won't say how many years ago, and now I've come full circle, and I'm working in the marketing department at Tanner. So I work on various campaigns, internal communications for all of our employees. I've been there 3 years this month.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah. And Dr. Grilliot, how about your history? How long have you been here, and what exactly do you do?
So I'm an obstetrician and gynecologist, so my job is to take care of women in all stages of their life. I've been here at Tanner for 11 years. In fact, yesterday may have been my Tannerversary of 11 years here in Carrollton. I came to Carrollton straight out of my training, so I did all of my medical training at UAB in Birmingham.
And is Alabama where you're from originally?
I am not. I'm actually from Ohio originally. Go Buckeyes.
Yeah. Thank you, ladies, for talking to us this morning. And again, promoting this campaign, an important campaign. Let's talk about the origins. What motivated Tanner to put this together? They felt like this is an important issue.
So, first off, life is precious, and unfortunately, we have a crisis going on in our country, and it's especially severe here in Georgia. So since 1987, the likelihood of a woman dying during or in the 12 months following pregnancy has significantly risen. So in 1987, that number came in at 7.2 per 100,000 women who gave birth actually passed away in that time frame. But since then, the number has risen to over 17. So the number has more than doubled despite all the other advances in medical care. We're seeing an actual increase in the likelihood of a woman dying during or in the 12 months following pregnancy.
Well, what were the causes when you look back at it in the 80s? What were some of the causes?
The causes are essentially the same. So the most likely reasons for a woman to die includes hemorrhage, so excess bleeding at the time of delivery. That one we've actually made significant improvements on. The likelihood of dying from that has improved. Other things that unfortunately have not improved are the risk of major cardiovascular, major heart events, the risk of a stroke, as well as issues related to high blood pressure and hypertension during pregnancy.
Well, is it being revealed that the mothers were less healthy when they're pregnant at this time? Were they just not taking care of themselves as much as they during pregnancy, or they come in with the existing conditions?
It's definitely multifactorial, so meaning there's a lot of factors involved. So one factor, for example, is this is not necessarily a bad thing, but women in the United States are delaying pregnancies. So it was pretty common before. We had I'm glad that our teen pregnancy rate is not as high as what it once was. But because of education, career goals, and I get that, I was in school and had career goals of myself. But because of those types of issues, women on average are older than what they were back in the 60s, 70s, 80s when they're having their families. And as we age, we are unfortunately more likely to develop chronic medical problems. So we're seeing higher rates of pre-existing high blood pressure, pre-existing hypertension. We're seeing much higher rates of pre-existing diabetes, higher rates of pre-existing heart problems already. And then obesity is a major factor as well. We do not have a healthy lifestyle in the United States, unfortunately. I'm probably not shocking anybody by saying that. And so obesity is a major issue, and we see it so commonly, especially here in the South.
in the South, I mean, I guess the answer might be obvious as far, you know, Georgia having the highest, second highest rate. I think Louisiana's first.
That's right. Louisiana has the overall highest rate, but Georgia is at the number two spot. So we talked about the national mortality rate, maternal mortality rate is 17.2, a little over 17 per 100,000. Mm-hmm. Here in Georgia, that number is 42 per 100,000. Mm-hmm. So our maternal mortality rate in Georgia is more than triple the, if my math is correct, or right about triple the national average.
And I think I know the answer to this as well. Is it because of just poor health in Georgia, or is it more that, you know, women in Georgia, maybe Atlanta, you know, waiting?
So again, a lot of factors involved. Yeah. Some of those health factors, like we talked about, there is also an issue with access to care. By far and away, the majority of counties in Georgia do not have an OBGYN at all that are available to them, especially in the South Georgia, in our more rural areas. We're very fortunate here in the West Georgia community. We have, oh goodness, how many of us are there? We have a new partner that just started this week. So I think there's currently 13 of us. So we have 13 board certified obstetricians and gynecologists that are here to provide care and take care of you. Even with that, however, there's a significant portion of women who don't come in for prenatal care that we do not meet until they show up at the hospital. I would say that number is probably in the ballpark of 15-20% of women do not receive prenatal care.
And why don't they receive it? Are they just not, can't be bothered with it? Are they insurance?
I don't know that I can specifically answer that question. A lot of it does have to do with insurance. You know, Georgia is one of the states that did not fill in the gap, so to speak, when it came to the Affordable Care Act and making sure that there was universal coverage. So there are still some difficulties in terms of gaining insurance coverage during pregnancy. And then, unfortunately, in some cases, I just think it's not pursued. It's a hassle to get put on, you know, if you don't have private insurance, it's a hassle to go through the process of getting approved for Medicaid. That the way the system works here in Georgia, they only provide approval once a month. So even if you applied right now, today's the 5th of August, mm-hmm. you still would not, and you did all your paperwork, you checked all the boxes, you did everything that you were supposed to do, you still would not have coverage until the 1st of September. And those 4 weeks can make a substantial difference.
Now, this might be unfair to bring up this question to you. I do remember Georgia working on the mortality rate. I don't, you know, the state.
Yes, there is work that's trying to be done. Again, we're not here to talk about politics today, mm-hmm. but one of our newly elected senators has taken this on. This is a U.S. senator, has taken this on. Senator Warnock has taken this on as one of his key issues to try to get this addressed nationally and here locally in Georgia.
I remember speaking with our local senator, Mike Dugan, about it last year, because it's always been something that's popped up on everybody's radar in the last couple of years.
I'm glad to hear that from Senator Dugan, our local state senator here as well, that this is definitely an issue that has come before the national representatives, but also here our state representatives, to try to address some of these concerns. One other concern, just again, when we're talking about insurance coverage and factors like that, when we're speaking about Medicaid, and which is the insurance that the majority of women in pregnancy are on, in the current situation here in Georgia, that insurance coverage ends somewhere between 6 weeks and 2 months postpartum. So they've just had a baby and they no longer have insurance coverage. The most likely time for a woman to die is in that time frame, is in the time following pregnancy, and they have no insurance coverage. So it's very hard for them to continue to come in and see us and for us to continue to monitor them, because they have no way of paying for it.
Well, it's not a new problem, but it's a fairly new campaign. Tanner's Better Birthdays, keeping moms and babies safe during pregnancy, childbirth, and beyond. My guest this morning, sitting to my left, Debbie Bolling. She talked a little bit in that first segment. We'll talk a little bit more to her. Sitting to my right is Dr. Megan Grilliot. She's OBGYN specialist with Tanner Healthcare for Women in Carrollton, serves as director of obstetrics and gynecology and medical operations leader of Women's and Children's Services for Tanner Health System. We'll take our first break. Again, we are on the News Talk 1330 Facebook page this morning, so if you have any questions or comments, feel free to post those up there, and I'll take a look and share those with our guests. Also, it's worth noting, our doctor this morning, she's been up for like 42 hours after delivering like 87 babies in the last 2 days.
A little bit of an exaggeration. You may notice that I look pretty sleepy this morning, and my eyes are bloodshot. I did come straight from the hospital this morning. I just worked about 26 hours and, yes, was up pretty much all night, but didn't quite deliver 86 babies.
Not quite.
Okay. Not quite.
Well, but thank you for coming here to talk about this important topic this morning. Our first break right now, our program brought to you by Tanner Health System and Oak Mountain Academy on News Talk 1330, FM 106.3.
Health is a journey. It's making better choices, even when it's not easy. It's taking care of yourself and the people you love. At Tanner Health System, we're there for you with every step, with primary care, heart care, cancer care, women's care, orthopedics, surgical services, and so much more. We're dedicated to helping you live and feel your best. So let's get on that journey to health. You've got places to be for many years to come. Find us at Tanner.org.
At Oak Mountain Academy, our daily schedule includes convocation, prayer, and the Pledge of Allegiance. By doing so, we build a family-like community where all students grow and flourish and personal faith is encouraged. Through community service and a historical approach to biblical study, our students are taught the value of the warrior way, honesty, respect, and responsibility. Oak Mountain Academy, we are a family creating legacies. To learn more, visit oakmountain.us.
And welcome back to the WLBB Community Voice Program here on News Talk 1330, FM 106.3. Also streaming live online at newstalk1330.com. I'm your host, Colin Worthington. Our guests this morning with Tanner Health System as we discuss a recent campaign, Better Birth Days. A lot of important information during that first segment. Hope you had a chance to hear it. If you miss any of it, it will be available on Facebook forever. And it'll be in a podcast form on our website at newstalk1330.com. Dr. Megan Grilliot, OBGYN specialist with Tanner Healthcare for Women, sitting to my right. So let's get into the warning signs.
Okay.
So, you know, what are some of the warning signs that potentially life-threatening pregnancy and birth complications?
So this is one of the most important things that I want to share with your listeners this morning, is those symptoms that should warrant immediate medical attention from women. So if you have a friend, a family member, a loved one in any way, sharing these things with you, my encouragement to you is to encourage her to either contact her OB provider immediately or to seek care at her closest emergency room. So those symptoms include a severe or persistent headache, that use of like an over-the-counter Tylenol, for example, is not getting rid of. Any difficulty breathing, tightness in your chest or shortness of breath warrants immediate attention. A rapid heart rate or what you feel is an irregular heart rate warrants immediate attention. Any fevers with temperatures over 100.4 needs to be evaluated as well. If you're having severe pain in the upper abdominal region, just under where your ribs end there, that again is not going away. Any severe nausea, vomiting, getting into more of our psychiatric issues, any thoughts of harming yourself or harming others is an emergency medical situation and should be treated as such. While you're pregnant, bleeding needs to be evaluated. Even a small amount of bleeding warrants contacting your obstetrician. If you think your water is broken or you're leaking fluid, again, you need to let us know what's going on. That's not something you just wait and see. And then after delivery, severe bleeding. So if you're bleeding to the point of, you know, having to change your sanitary pads or tampons in less than an hour, again, warrants evaluation. Any sort of lightheadedness, dizziness, feelings like you're going to pass out, hopefully you would come in and seek evaluation for that. And then finally, any severe swelling in your legs or arms, especially if that swelling is associated with pain in that area or redness in that area.
Now, these symptoms individually or collectively?
Any of them.
Yeah.
Any one of them.
Well, how common are the complications? And
Complications in pregnancy are relatively common. I would like to tell you that, you know, coming into having a baby is just like it looks on TV. You know, you're standing on the sidewalk, you experience a gush of fluid, you know, you turn to that clip of screaming, and next thing you know, you're holding a baby. And, you know,
it's that easy.
Yeah. It's just like that. It's just like that. And occasionally it is, but the truth is those completely uncomplicated pregnancies these days are few and far between. So the risk, for example, of hypertensive disorders in pregnancy nationally, the studies show a likelihood of experiencing hypertension issue during pregnancy, such as gestational hypertension is one term for it, chronic hypertension, which is longstanding hypertension even outside of pregnancy, preeclampsia or eclampsia. Nationally, the data is around 15%. But I will tell you here locally, what we experience is probably higher. It's probably more like 40%. Mm-hmm. It is a large portion of our patients. We are managing blood pressure issues during their pregnancy. That's just one example.
Well, families who they talk about, maybe talk about having a child for a year and
sure.
plans. What advice do you give? What recommendations do you give in prep for this, so that you
yes.
know, to nip this in the bud before you really have to be concerned about it down the
so
road?
So ideally, you're coming in to see us prior to even trying for a pregnancy. So those yearly checkups that we recommend for all women is a great opportunity to start talking about things that we can modify prior to even attempting pregnancy. Making sure that there's not some lifestyle changes that we might recommend for you in terms of diet, in terms of exercise, trying to get your weight to the ideal place. Again, easier said than done, but those are the kind of goals that we would talk about. If there are chronic medical problems, if there is pre-existing hypertension or diabetes, for example, two of the most common ones that we see, making sure that that is as well controlled as possible, that you are in a stable place before pregnancy is pursued, is very important.
When you have those conversations, how serious do you see mothers and potential mothers and fathers take that advice?
Well, that's another hard question. Mm-hmm. So some of them take it very seriously, but we do, the truth is that certain lifestyle habits I think are ingrained in us, and it's the way we were raised, it's the way that our family carries on in their life. So making some of those changes is definitely much easier said than done. Mm-hmm. So I don't think there's anybody who doesn't desire to be as healthy as possible and doesn't desire as healthy of a pregnancy as possible for themselves and for their unborn child. But putting some of those changes, making those a reality can be very difficult. Mm. We try to work closely with our other specialists. So in some cases, we're getting cardiology involved. In some cases, we're getting dietitians involved, physical therapists, if that's appropriate. So trying to build some support around these women to try to help motivate those types of changes.
So it was just 55 years ago where mothers were still smoking and drinking.
Oh, pregnant, yes.
Right?
Yes.
And probably a little bit after that. But
yes, yeah. yes. And we still see some of that. Unfortunately, use of tobacco products are significantly less than what they were, 20, 30 years ago. But we do still see tobacco use during pregnancy. Marijuana use is so common. And I think women underestimate the effects of marijuana during pregnancy. We see it all the time. Occasionally alcohol, occasionally illicit drug use is still an issue. But the most common thing we see is either tobacco or marijuana use.
Is there a difference in mortality rates as far as race or...
Absolutely. That's one of the most concerning things that we know from this data is that Black women are much more likely to die in pregnancy than their than their white and non-Hispanic counterparts. So again, the data comes in, this is national data, says overall mortality rate again was around 17 per 100,000. For Caucasian non-Hispanic women, that number comes out at about 14.7. For black women, the number is, again, let me get the exact number. I don't want to get it wrong. 41.7. So,
that's significant.
Again,
yeah.
Three times more likely nationally for a black woman to die during or following pregnancy than what her white counterpart is. Here in Georgia, the numbers are at least that bad, if not more. Depending on the study that you read, the difference is somewhere between there's one study that showed a 6-time higher likelihood for a black woman to die in the state of Georgia than her white counterpart.
And the next question is why?
So again, multifactorial, meaning a lot of factors are going into that. So there's the medical factors that we talked about before, the possibility of pre-existing medical conditions. There's also the concerns about access to care. And the quality of care that they receive. We also know as a medical community, this is well established. There's data that support that structural racism is real. Implicit bias within the medical system is real. And that too is concerning. Unfortunately, the outcry of black women in terms of what they were experiencing historically has simply just not been taken as seriously.
Time right now is 8:52. We'll take our final break here. This morning's program, we're discussing Better Birthdays, a recent campaign from Tanner Health System, keeping moms and babies safe during pregnancy, childbirth, and beyond. And our guest this morning, Debbie Boulding, sitting to my left, and Dr. Megan Grilliot, sitting to my right. Questions and comments, again, with about 8 minutes left in the program, I encourage you to post them to the News Talk 1330 Facebook page, and I'll take a look at those during this break, and we'll come back and conclude our program. Community Voice, brought to you by Tanner Health System, Oak Mountain Academy, on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3.
Health is a journey. It's making better choices, even when it's not easy. It's taking care of yourself and the people you love. At Tanner Health System, we're there for you with every step, with primary care, heart care, cancer care, women's care, orthopedics, surgical services, and so much more. We're dedicated to helping you live and feel your best. So let's get on that journey to health. You've got places to be for many years to come. Find us at Tanner.org.
At Oak Mountain Academy, our academic excellence shines through innovation and a personalized educational experience. Our pre-K 3 through 12th grade environment offers a family-oriented atmosphere. We are an independent school with faith-based values and an academy honor code. Our academic standards prepare our students for college and beyond. I'm Patrick Duran, headmaster, inviting you to visit us on the mountain or at oakmountain.us. Come see how our warriors are creating legacies.
Welcome back to the WLBB Community Voice here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3. I'm your host this morning, Colin Worthington. We're discussing Tanner Health System's recent campaign, Better Birthdays, Keeping Moms and Babies Safe During Pregnancy, Childbirth, and Beyond. We're going to bring Debbie back into the program here and talk about this. I mean, to have a campaign, obviously we're talking about it on this morning's program, but I assume that you're going to, that maybe are there posters up around Tanner, or are you guys talking to civic groups? What does a campaign involve?
We're doing all of that, Colin, and thank you so much for the opportunity to be here today. Awareness is so important when we're talking about health conditions and to keep our pregnant and recently delivered moms and their babies safe. So we have, first of all, a website that we have put together. It's called tanner.org/betterbirthdays, and it has a lot of the information that Dr. Grilliot has shared, you know, what to watch for, what to do. We've got a great video that really brings it to life. So we encourage folks to go and visit that. We have also partnered with some of our great community organizations, such as the Carroll County Health Department, the Pregnancy Resource Center. For every woman who receives a positive pregnancy test, they receive literature from us on Better Birthdays that outlines a lot of this important information, and it's in English and in Spanish. We're also talking to civic groups, making this information available. It's the community as well as those individual moms who are needed to support and help them recognize that maybe that headache isn't just a headache, and you need to get it checked out. So we really want to build this great awareness throughout our community that this is an issue and there is something that we can do about it.
It's not like there's an end date for this campaign either. It's not like you'll just stop it one day and say, all right, we're done.
No, we're not going to stop caring about maternal lives. We're not going to stop caring about our families. So this is an ongoing effort.
All right, again, we're discussing the Better Birthdays campaign through Tanner Health System on this morning's Community Voice program. Have about 5 minutes left. I'm trying to think if there's anything else really important that we should get across. You know, we've said that maybe one of the issues why parents may not be able, potential parents don't treat themselves better when they find out they're pregnant. Is the insurance, access to insurance. Are there any groups locally? I mean, how, you know, what's their alternative? What's their option?
So the best option is, if they don't have private insurance, is to see about coverage in terms of Medicaid. The standards for qualifying for Medicaid during pregnancy are different than those outside of pregnancy. The income levels are different. The health department can help facilitate that. It is a bit of a cumbersome process. The health department can help facilitate that. And I believe the Pregnancy Resource Center can also help facilitate that. That is a nonprofit organization in our community that often do those initial ultrasounds, help provide those initial resources, get them set up with an appointment with one of the OBGYN offices in town. And again, they can help to try to get that insurance coverage in place.
Very good. If there's a family discussing, considering having having a child, how do they get in touch with you to set up that appointment?
Yeah, so our number is 770-214-2121.
I know Debbie has a something that she wants to make sure we talk about, but I think we have a couple of comments on the Facebook page real quick that I want to shout out before we cancel the program. Dr. Grilliot, thanks for highlighting all the issues you're raising here. That's from Juan Carlos Ferrero. And John Armstrong says, thanks, Doc, for highlighting the uncomfortable facts in our healthcare system. All right, about 2 minutes left in the program. And again, Debbie, something you wanted to announce, an event that's coming up?
Yes. Well, obviously, you know, COVID-19 is still very much with us. It's growing in our community. We're wearing our mask. Also, vaccination is critical to helping prevent the spread of disease. And we have a vaccination clinic coming up this Friday. It's going to be at Tabernacle Baptist Church from 9:30 until 2:30. It's going to be part of the Carrollton Civic Women's Club annual yard sale. And we're going to be there with Pfizer vaccine. We'll be able to vaccinate anyone 12 and over. Obviously, anyone under 18 requires a parent or guardian. But we encourage that you make an appointment. You can go online at tanner.org/takemyshot and save your spot. If you show up and you're looking for those great yard sale finds and want to get your vaccine, we'll try to work you in as well.
And again, to hit home the point that those numbers are going up as far as positive tests and hospital cases. Last Thursday, I believe 44 people were within the Tanner Health System hospitals occupying the beds. That number has risen over the last week.
It has. So our the last update I received is that number is now over 60. Our ICU here in Carrollton is full, with the majority of those being COVID positive patients. And the final thing that I will say is we do encourage during pregnancy that vaccination is received. So we now have enough data regarding the risks of COVID specifically during pregnancy, the risk to mom as well as the risk to baby. And we also have enough data regarding the safety of the vaccine during pregnancy. Mm. So pregnant or not, vaccination is certainly encouraged, as well as use of masks, social distancing, quarantining when appropriate. All those measures still need to be in place.
All right, thank you.
And Colin, that vaccine clinic is going to be done in conjunction with Carrollton Civic Women's Club.
Very good. Debbie, good to see you again. Doc, good to meet you. And appreciate you listening to us this morning on the Community Voice and watching us on the News Talk 1330 Facebook page. I believe Tanner will probably share the Facebook program later on in the day. So if you have additional questions, I'm sure you can post those to their Facebook page, and I'm sure somebody will try to address those. Stay tuned now for national headlines, followed by your local news here on News Talk 1330, FM 106.3. Have a great Wednesday.